We're going to see our son and his fiancée and our beautiful grandson.
Pretty special. They don't even know we're coming. We're surprising them.
Just so exciting. I can't believe it's quite here.
We are moving home. Yeah, moving back to New Zealand.
For the 62,000 Aussies living across the ditch and nearly 600,000 New Zealanders here, the return of quarantine-free travel couldn't come quickly enough.
I've got two little ones. They're dying to see their grandma.
Been in a long-distance relationship with my partner since early April. And finally now, that's where I'm heading.
Just a massive hug. I really, really missed
it. I've ordered the works, the meal and everything, so going to really enjoy it.
And the first Trans-Tasman arrivals received rousing receptions. In Auckland, the traditional Dave Dobbin cover. In Melbourne, whatever the hell this is. For the airline industry, it's a badly needed shot in the arm. No pun intended.
From July onwards, Jetstar will be at 120% of its pre-COVID levels. Qantas are 107%. And we're adding 16 return flights a day to New Zealand in the fall.
Just these flights alone means another 50 jobs in the airport for retailers.
We've gotten 630 people back to work just because of this bubble.
We're hoping that, you know, towards the back end of this year that we might be able to look at countries with similar numbers to ours to potentially have those travel bubbles.
But dreams of a steady stream of travel bubbles were burst by the PM.
The international borders are also an incredibly important protection for Australians. And I'm not about to relax those restrictions lightly.
Luckily for lots of Aussies and Kiwis, this bubble is enough for now.
Thank you, Savannah. I'm here.
Thank goodness, yeah. Australia, we're here.
No, I'm ecstatic to see you. I missed you so much.
Yeah.
So grateful, honestly, so grateful.
So, so excited. He's 5 months old.
A bit emotional.
I'm like shaking right now.
And news just in, there's been an outbreak.
Oh, stop it.
You know what? I was actually thinking doing the same thing, and I thought, no, that would be irresponsible.
No, I'm allowed to get away. It's more serious when you say it.
Who would have ever thought it would be so exciting to go to New Zealand?
Oh, I've always loved New Zealand.
Yeah, I love New Zealand too, but boy, people are getting excited about it.
It's great. If they could do this with Singapore, Fiji, some other places. I feel like what we need, though, is some defined rules around when borders would, you know, shut quickly. I think that's the problem once we're going to start doing this. If each state has different decisions about when you could be on holiday, and then you're like, oh, shivers, have I got till midnight tonight or tomorrow night to get home? All of that. If we could just define that, I feel like we could do this for a few years even, maybe.
So lock us all up and off from the rest of the world.
No, but if we're not open to the rest of the world yet, Pricey. When was the last time?
But how long do you think we can actually stay that way?
Well, it depends. If we slowly open up, maybe we can
creep into the Pacific, get into Fiji.
Yeah,
Fiji's beautiful.
But as you missed it, Carrie said shivers earlier. it's a great expression. I love it. Shivers my timbers.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.